Hello everyone, welcome to the course of Microwave Engineering. In today's class, we are going to discuss about two cavity klystron amplifier. So before getting into two cavity klystron amplifier, we need to know actually what are klystrons. So we can put it in a simple way, like a klystron is a vacuum tube that can be used as an oscillator as well as an amplifier. Okay, if we see the diagram here, the center cylindrical part, which looks like a pipeline structure, is made of a glass, and it's a glass tube where we are calling it as a klystron, where a klystron is a vacuum tube that can be used for oscillator as well as amplifier, where we all know an oscillator is used for generating an oscillations, which leads to generation of frequency, whereas an amplifier is used for strengthening the weak signal. So these kind of klystrons, so we have klystron oscillators as well as klystron amplifiers. This topic we are going to discuss about two cavity klystron amplifier, in which how we are going to strengthen the weak signal. That's what we are going to see in this topic. So this glass tube is a klystron, which we can also call it as a vacuum tube, which can be used as oscillator for generating frequencies and also can be used as an amplifier for strengthening the weak signal. Now, coming to our topic, two cavity klystron amplifier. So this two cavity klystron amplifier is basically a velocity modulated tube. So what are those two cavities? How they are fixed to the klystron amplifier? How the signal is getting strengthened? And how this tube uses a velocity modulation, we will be seeing. The two cavity klystron amplifier, what you are seeing here is a little bit complicated diagram. So I will simplify this diagram and I will explain it clearly step by step. Okay. So this is a simplified diagram of a two cavity klystron amplifier, where you can see this rectangular part over here is a glass tube, which we are calling it as an klystron tube, or you can also call it as vacuum tube, where based on the application, it can be used either for an oscillator or as an amplifier. Now, for this, let me take the pencil. Okay. Now, for this glass tube, okay, one end of the glass tube is connected to an negative of the supply, and other end of the glass tube is connected to the positive of the supply, where the negative is connected to the electron gun, which we are considering it as an cathode, and the positive terminal of the supply is connected to an other end of the glass tube, which we are calling it as anode, or we can also call it as a collector. So whenever a supply is given over here, okay, whenever a supply is given over here, the electrons will travel from this point to this point. So whenever supply is given, the electron gun starts generating electrons. So electrons will be captured at the collector end, that is what at anode. Okay. So this is a simplified diagram of a two cavity klystron amplifier, where first we need to consider the glass tube. So here, as we have already seen in the previous diagram, this is a simplified diagram of it. So this middle part, okay, let me show you. So this middle part is our vacuum tube or a glass tube, which are used as an oscillator or as an amplifier. Okay. So as per this topic is concerned, we are using this as an amplifier. That's what we are calling it as two cavity klystron amplifier. Now this vacuum tube has two ends. One is at the electron gun end and another one is the collector end. Okay. Now, we need to give negative supply, negative of the supply to this electron gun and the positive terminal to this collector end, such that whenever a supply is given, the electrons will be traveling from this particular cathode towards anode, which we are nothing but collector. So that means whenever a supply is given, the electrons start moving from the electron gun towards this particular collector, which we are calling it as anode. So this is how the electrons travel. Whenever we give supply, the electrons will be traveling from here to the collector end. This is how they travel. Okay. Now we have seen the vacuum tube as well as supply. Now the next comes the cavities. Here we can see, as our topic title is concerned, we are using two cavities, right? So here we have cavity one and this is our cavity two. Okay, so the cavity one is called as a buncher cavity, and you can also call it as input cavity. And the cavity two is called as catcher cavity, and it also can be called as output cavity. Okay, so the radio frequency signals will be collected from, will be taken as an input from this buncher cavity. So the radio frequency signals will be received from this buncher cavity, and the output as of an radio frequency signals will be collected at this output cavity. So our radio frequency signals will be given as an input from this cavity, as well as it goes, the amplified output will be coming through this output. So one is the buncher, where we are giving input, radio frequency input, and another cavity is the catcher, where they are collecting radio frequency output, which is in the amplified form. So initially, if you see, first one is the glass tube, and this glass tube or the vacuum tube is connected with, or this electron gun, whole electron gun is, electron tube is connected with this supply. So first one is the vacuum tube, second one is the supply, and the third one is our cavities. Okay, electron gun is connected to negative terminal of the supply, and the positive terminal of the supply is connected to the anode, which is nothing but collector. And the cavities, one is input cavity, which we are calling it as buncher, where radio frequencies will be given as an input, and the second one is the output cavity, where the radio frequency, amplified radio frequency, you need to remember, amplified radio frequency will be collected as an output. Okay, now as the RF signal is given through this cavity or an input cavity or a buncher cavity, how they are getting amplified. Okay, let's see one by one. So as the supply is switched on, what happens initially, the electrons from the electron gun starts traveling from cathode to anode. So this is how, what happens. Okay, so whatever the electrons are started from the electron gun or emitted from the electron gun, they will be collected at the anode, or they will be collected at the collector end. Now as the electrons are traveling from the cathode to anode side, whenever there is an incoming of an RF signal through here, okay, income of an RF signal through here, these RF frequency will be get in contact with these electrons, through which the velocity of this radio frequency signal will be increased. Okay, so that's what we are calling it as a velocity modulation, or the velocity. Okay, initially when an RF signal is coming through this buncher cavity, it will be having less velocity. As this radio frequency comes through this buncher cavity and gets in contact with these electrons, the velocity of the radio frequency will be increased. Okay, such that there will be a huge speed of radio frequency traveling from this buncher cavity to this catcher cavity. Okay. Now we need to see whenever the supply is given. Let me clear this. So one thing is there is a glass tube or a vacuum tube. The second one is negative terminal is connected to the electron gun and positive terminal is connected to the anode or the collector of an vacuum tube. The third one is we are using two cavities. One is buncher cavity to take the RF input and one is catcher cavity to take the output of an RF, which is an amplified output. Okay. Initially, whenever we give supply, the electron gun start emitting electrons. These electrons will be received at the collector end. Okay. So initially when the electron gun start receiving the transmitting the electrons, okay, this is the electrons initially reaches this particular area. Okay. And this, as it reaches from here to here, if at all there is an incoming of a radio frequency, this radio frequency gets in contact with these electrons which are flowing, and this leads to the increase of velocity of the radio frequency, through which the signal, if there is a weak signal, it will get amplified. Okay. Now these electrons keep on traveling through here, and the distance between the input cavity as well as output cavity is called as drift space. Okay. We have two cavities, right? One is buncher cavity or input cavity. Another one is catcher cavity or output cavity, right? So the distance between input cavity as well as output cavity, or the distance between buncher cavity or the catcher cavity, is considered as drift space. Now, initially, the electrons, as it got emitted from the electron gun, it travels till gap A. So at this point, we can see gap A. The distance between electron gun as well as buncher cavity or input cavity is considered as gap A. And the distance between catcher cavity and the collector is considered as gap B. Okay. So as the electrons are traveling from the electron gun, it first electrons need to travel till gap A. Again, electrons will travel through drift space, and again electrons will travel through gap B. Now these electrons will be experiencing three stages. One is gap A, and one is drift space, and the third one is gap B. These electrons will be traveling through these three spaces: gap A, drift space, as well as gap B. Okay. Now the electrons which has reached collector, okay, at this particular electrons are called as early electrons. So early electrons. Okay. So the electrons which has reached the collector are called as early electrons. I will be explaining all these stages. And the electrons which are between input cavity as well as output cavity, or the electrons which are between buncher cavity and catcher cavity, are called as reference electrons. Reference electrons. Okay. Now the electrons which are between electron gun as well as buncher cavity, they are called as late electrons. Okay. So whenever as soon as the electron gun emits the electrons, these electrons will be going through three phases. Okay. As the electrons moving from electron gun to the buncher cavity, that will be calling it as late electrons. As the electrons are moving from between buncher cavity to between catcher cavity, they are called as reference electrons. And the electrons which are reached collector, okay, between the catcher and the collector, they are called as early electrons. So these electrons will be experiencing three phases: early electrons, reference electrons, and late electrons. Okay, whenever the radio frequencies from the buncher cavity gets in contact with these electrons, there will be an increase in velocity of these electrons or as well as radio frequency, which leads to amplification of the signal. So as this radio frequency gets in contact with these electrons, it gets amplified and it will be collected as a bunches in electron bunches. So here all the electrons will be captured as a bunches, and these signals will be given through a cavity as an output through catcher cavity. Okay, so initially electrons will be traveling from electron gun through anode with three phases. They are early electrons, reference electrons, and late electrons. Whenever a radio frequency signal gets in through the buncher cavity and gets in contact with the electrons, the velocity of the radio frequency gets increased, and this leads to the amplification of the signal, and these electrons will be captured in the form of bunches or in the form of packets. And these captured bunches are traveled through this catcher cavity as a radio frequency output. So as this has been as the velocity of this particular radio frequency has been increased, there will be an amplified signal, or the weak signal will be strengthened. Okay, so on the whole, a vacuum tube is connected with a supply, where whenever a supply is provided, the electrons will be traveling from the cathode to anode. Okay, as the electrons are traveling from cathode to anode, it will be experiencing three phases. One is late phase, one is reference phase, and one is early phase. Okay, now as we are using cavities for input and output of the RF signals, whenever an RF signal gets in contact with these electrons through the buncher cavity, the velocity of the RF signal or the electrons will get increased, due to which there will be an amplification of the signal. Now the amplified signal will be formed into electron bunches, and that will be collected through an RF output through catcher cavity. So that's why these cavities are used for taking the input and giving the output, which is an amplified output. So on the whole, what you need to concentrate is, you need to concentrate on the glass tube or the vacuum tube, which is connected to a negative and positive terminals. Positive terminal is considered as collector, negative terminal is considered as your electron gun. So when the electrons are traveling from electron gun to the collector, it will be experiencing three: early electrons, reference electrons, and late electrons. Okay, so whenever the RF signal through buncher cavity gets in contact with these electrons, there will be a modulation of the velocity through which the amplification of the signal is done, and that will be formed into electron bunches, and these electron bunches will be carried out through RF output, where we are getting an amplified signal. Okay, so the difference or the distance between electron gun and a buncher cavity is considered as gap A. The distance between buncher cavity and catcher cavity is considered as drift space, and the distance between catcher cavity and the collector is considered as gap B. Okay, this is how an RF signal, which is given as an input through buncher cavity, is amplified and is taken from a catcher cavity through an RF output. Now let's see the graphical representation of this. So we generally call it as an apple gate diagram. So whatever the concept we have seen here, okay, same concept will be represented in the form of a graphical representation. Okay, so this is an apple gate diagram or a graphical representation of a klystron amplifier. We can also call it as a two cavity klystron amplifier. Okay, so what we have seen in the previous diagram explanation, as when the supply is given, the electron gun start emitting electrons from the electron gun towards the collector or an anode, right? So as the electrons are traveling, they will be experiencing three phases. One is late electrons, one is reference electrons, and one is early electrons, right? Okay, so we will be seeing these kind of three kinds of electrons in a different gaps, and we can also see the graphical representation over here clearly. So this is an apple gate diagram of a two cavity klystron amplifier. Here we can clearly see, as the electrons are moving from one point to another point, how the velocity differs. Okay, so let's see, this is a graphical representation of a circle of an electron cycle moving from positive to negative or negative to positive. With respect to these, we can see three phases of electrons. One is late electrons, one is reference electrons, and one is early electrons. And these three phases, and we can also see the drift space. So this is the drift space where the main velocity modulation differs. So drift space, what we have seen is, it's a distance between the buncher cavity as well as the catcher cavity. So between this buncher cavity as well as catcher cavity, how these electrons are velocity is varying with respect to phases of electrons, we'll be seeing it right now. So let's see the step by step how the velocity is modulated with respect to the phase of electrons. Okay, so this is a cycle which is moving from positive to the negative cycle, and we can see the first phase where, as the electron starts moving, it will be then late electrons, as it is, these electrons are nearer to the electron gun, right? So at this late electrons, the velocity will be always high. Okay, now the next phase comes the reference phase. This reference phase will be between the buncher cavity as well as the catcher cavity. At this phase, reference electrons, the velocity will be always equal. Okay, so next comes the phase of early electrons. As the electrons reaching the collector are considered as the early electrons, at this particular state, the velocity will be less. So what we are experiencing here is, we are just seeing the velocity modulation of different velocity modulation at different stages of these electrons, early electrons, reference electrons, as well as late electrons. This is the graphical representation of the whole concept of a two cavity klystron amplifier or two cavity klystron amplifier. Okay, so let's see the applications of two cavity klystron amplifiers. So these two cavity klystron amplifiers are majorly used in 3V transmitters, radar communications, and satellite communications, etc.